Right. Good afternoon, everybody. Hope you're doing well. Let's not beat around the bush. Let's just get on with it. I'm trying to find the last Polaroid in Ash Canyon. Once I've done that, I'll be out of Ash Canyon and on the road to other things. Now I have, although Long Dark Forever gave me a list of all the possible locations of the Polaroids, I did go looking for them myself, and I looked them up, the positions up online, just in case there was anything I missed, and it looks like there isn't. So so I've got this one last section to check out, and then that is it. After that, I've got to go back to the cave. While the storm is raging, let's harvest all this down. Hopefully by the time I've done these boots, okay, maybe not. Have I got anything to create fire? Probably not. I'm not using coal. Coal is going to become important towards the mid and end game, so I am not going to use it. Not anymore. Okay, and as soon as it starts, as quickly as it starts, it stops, right. Now then, I'm just going to quickly pull up the map that I've got on Google. We are over at Stone Shelf Cave, which is here, and apparently the last map, the last possible place for it to be is somewhere in here. Just pull up the map. Yeah, it's supposed to be somewhere in this area, so we're going to have a real good look. Like I say, if I can't find it on this run, then I will leave it for now, and when I come to do all the Polaroids, the rest of the Polaroids that I haven't got, it's only 13, so if I get another 7, I've already got 6, if I get another 7, then obviously it wasn't meant to be. Now there is a fallen tree bridge up here somewhere. Okay, obviously I dropped all my charcoal at some point. It's unlike me. I suppose the good thing about charcoal is as long as you can get a fire going, you can get charcoal. Okay, so the path we are looking for is just in front of us. I'm still having a shifty round just to see if there's anything I need to know about. Any plastic containers around here. Can't see anything. Okay. No. Okay, so this is the path that leads to the fallen bridge. Let's have a quick shifty. Almost looks like a path up there. Wonder if they've gone and done the sneaky hidey sneaky sneakies. I thought that was going to be a secret cache then. So this is the area, this is the only area left that I haven't thoroughly searched. So if I can't find the Polaroid in here, then I'm just gonna have to assume, for now anyway, that the thing is glitched. Or it was never meant to be here in this run. One of the two. wonder if you can get up over there. I doubt it, but it might be worth a check. Don't think it'll be up here. I mean, sure they'd put it. Sure they might put it somewhere difficult to get to, but they wouldn't put it in somewhere inaccessible. Would they? No, they wouldn't. Does Wolf's Jaw overlook? Right. Nothing up here then. Nothing up here. No boxes. crates. Okay. So what I'll do is I'm gonna make my way back to the cave that takes us to Timberwolf Mountain, and for now we're going to say goodbye to Ash Canyon. So, spent what, about 10 days, 10 real-time days in Ash Canyon? And, yeah, what can I say about Ash Canyon? Certainly not a place you want to visit twice unless you have to. I, unfortunately, am going to have to visit the place twice. Because I have a feeling, I have a funny feeling, that I'm going to have to come back to get the Polaroid. Which is not going to be pleasant. What else can I say about Ash Canyon? Yeah, definitely do not visit Ash Canyon unless you've got at least the key skills at level 3. Yeah, and when I say the key skills, I mean things like your carcass harvesting, the cooking, your fire starting, your ice fishing, and your firearms. And your mending have got to be at least level 3 before you come here. Not so much the archery, or the revolver, or the gunsmithing. Gunsmithing, I wouldn't worry about too much. Because let's face it, the only place that's ever going to come into play is Bleak Inlet, because that's the only place you can smith at the moment, gunsmith. But yeah, archery is good to have, but not essential on Ash Canyon, unless of course you're playing Interloper, in which case archery very much becomes important. Yeah, the other ones not so much. crow feather. Oh, hello. Okay. Right, so for now everybody, we wave bye bye to Ash Canyon. Whether we'll be back or not, I don't know, but for now we wave bye bye. Stop trying to light the friggin' matches. Oh, that's pathetic. Okay. Welcome to the pack, Hunden. Welcome to the stream. Just mean to go the wrong way. Is now, can I remember my way back? Hey Fallout, how you doing? Oh dear. I'm sorry to hear that. Do you know what it is, or you're not sure? Hot tea is always a good idea. This is why I brought spray paint. Okie dokie. This is stupid. What's going on here then? This is why I'm marked the way. This is a no-go. Not long from burning out. This leads me back to Ash Canyon. I will not be happy. Really? Really? Really, because all that does is just stand you up again. Okay, it's marine flare. I didn't want to light marine flare. Never mind. All our equipment. Stay in the cave for the rest of the night. Transport everything outside the cave in the morning. For now, let's get some sleep. Joking. Okay. I dropped the bedroll there. Actually, might as well get another hour's sleep. 2 hours sleep, so we've got some daylight in the cave. Except it doesn't look like we're going to get daylight in the cave. Okay. What source of light do we have? Then and that and that. will spend time at Timberwolf Mount, at the Mountaineering Hut, actually, turning all the birch saplings into arrow shafts. And I've got two arrowheads, so I can already create two two arrows. Okay, drop that. Okay, so we are now back in Timberwolf Mountain. We are actually up here. Lost them here at Timberwolf Mountain. I might as well, like I say, one of the things I'm going to do is create a load of arrow shafts, and also create a couple of bows, because why not? I am going to have to take one of these deer down, because I haven't got any food left. Want to, but I'm gonna have to. With the improvised for now. What is my hunting skill at? 3. Increased range, accuracy range increased by 20%. Oh, the irony of this game sometimes. If you look up what this rifle is meant to do, then you'll understand the reason why I'm laughing. Basically, in game, I can understand why they've done it. I've dropped on the water as well. In game, the rifle's only got a certain range until you start leveling up. Yeah, in the real world, I've done my research on this, so I thought it was quite funny. In the real world, this rifle has got a lethal range. I've got to remember what it is now. I think it's a lethal range of 900 yards, and a total range of something like 1200. So, in other words, that deer there both those deers with this rifle, as long as I could see it anywhere around here, no problem. But in the game, if you're on level 1 and you aim at there, that deer there, you got a 50-50 chance of hitting. Cave over there that didn't mark. Shit! Did I even hit it? Yeah, I did. Put its head down right at the wrong second. Still my fault. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to do that. But I did mean to do that, I didn't mean to cause you suffering.
I would drink almost anything about now.
See what water we've got. Okay, so it doesn't look like we've got any water. Right. First things first, let's get some water on the go. No, we are not burning the coal. Coal is very valuable, or it is in a later stage anyway. Right. Okay, so cook all this meat up. Gonna spend the night in this cave, and then when I come back to this game, and it won't be tomorrow, it'll be a little while now before I come back to this game, because I feel a little bit burnt out. And it happens, don't get me wrong, I absolutely adore this game. It is amazing, and I absolutely love it. Ugh. I'm just burnt out on it. Plus, I've got another game that I'm going to be playing, and I'll explain that when I do start playing it. But again, we'll see how things go. But let's sleep. Okay, right, that is it for me today. I know it's been slightly shorter than normal stream. I mean, I don't normally do more than 2 hours anyway. But I won't be coming back to this game for a little while. When I say a little while, I mean a couple of weeks, something like that. But next time I stream, I will be moving on to a different game, and I will explain all of that when I actually come to do it. In the meantime, thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you later. Bye for now.